Hello, welcome to the class of HTML5 programming. So today we are going to discuss about the role of preferences in HTML program, or we can also say that the cascade. So here the cascade or the rule of preference in HTML applies the style in order from outermost to the innermost. The outermost are like external style sheet, the embedded style sheet, and the innermost such as the HTML attributes that are coded in the HTML codes. So the rule of preference is given like this. First of all, the preference is given to the browser content, after that to the external style, and then the preference is given to the embedded style, and then to the inline style, and at the last the preferences are given to the HTML attribute. So we know that the external style sheets can be applied to multiple pages. So let's suppose a scenario: if a web page contains both a link to an external style sheet followed by a embedded style sheet, so then what happen? Then the preference will be given to external style sheet first, and then the embedded style sheet will be applied. And take a next scenario where if a web page contains both the embedded style and the inline style, then what happens? Again the same, the embedded style sheet have high preference, so that it will be applied first and then the inline style. So embedded style will apply first and the inline style will be applied next to that. Same thing will happen if we apply this rule to the HTML attributes or the tags. So let's suppose we have used a strong tag and a font related properties styles are applied in HTML program. Again the preference will be given to the attributes as compared to the font properties. So now here I have designed this program. Now look at this program. Here I use the CSS style rules. So there is two CSS style rule. A rule created a class named special, that is this, that configure the text format to Arial, and sorry, text format to the cursive, and the font style to the italics. So a rule that configures the paragraph, it will use the font style as Times New Roman. So now let's look at the browser, how will it display this program, how it give the preferences to these two styles. Go to run and launch in Chrome. So it will display this code in this format. So here you can see that. Let's discuss how the browser decode the code. So first of all, the text contained in the heading 1 is displayed with cursive font, because it is part of div assigned to special class, because here we have declared this division element with the class attribute and the class name as special. So in special selector we have declared the font family as cursive and its font style is italic. So it is showing this telcoma global part in cursive and italic form. So it is a part of div as element assigned to the special class. So here it inherits the property from its parent class. This is example of inheritance. So in HTML the text related properties such as font family, colors are inherited, but the box related properties such as margin, padding, they are not inherited from their parent class. So now let's discuss about the next part, the text that is contained in the paragraph. So this will be displayed in Times New Roman font, because the browser applies the style associated with the most local element. So paragraph is its local element, and it will give the preference to the style that is applied to the local element as compared to its class or the division element. So this will take the preference over the special class style. So here you can see that this paragraph display this text in Times New Roman format, and it's use this font style italics, because we have covered this paragraph in this division element. So in this way the HTML use the rules of preferences to style the web pages. So this is all about this is all about the rule of preferences in HTML program. Thank you.